So for today's hike and climb tour, we are at Absam, at the starting of the Halltal. We have to walk 1 hour until we can finally start climbing. We will go up to 2000 meters, and my assumption is we'll need about 5 hours to get to the little wolf hut. The descent is a hiking trail, not so easy, but it's okay. Will take us maybe 3 hours for the complete descent. About the climbing area, the Via Ferrata of Absam is, well, except 2 or 3 positions, not so difficult. Most challenging is you need to quite a long time to get through it, and it might get very warm. So think about having several bottles of water with you, else you might get a dehydration problem. Today it's a bit cloudy, so we are lucky we will not end up with too much heat. Okay, let's see for the next sprint. We're getting closer. Still about half an hour to go. This road is a dead-end road, and it's closed for public. But the few cars are allowed, most especially a hiking taxi. And as you can see, it's quite steep here. And in the background, you can see already the wall, which really climbs. Also nice to see here the bicycles. A lot of people come up here with a bike and then they hike or climb. so they save a little bit of weight, and maybe it's not so exhausting if you go here with your e-bike. Okay. Quite a lot of traffic for this morning. It's past 9 o'clock today, we are quite late. If you're early in this valley, you might see several animals, several wild animals. But the later in the morning, they will go to the forest or up to the peak of the mountain. Okay, there we go, off the road, away from comfortable. Now we have another 15 minutes on the hiking trail. Nice water. Quite exhausting. Okay, a few words about this Via Ferrata. It will take us about 3.5, maybe 4 hours to get through it. It's difficulty BC. For my opinion, personal opinion, there are 3 points which are a bit challenging. First of all, the entry point, the so-called key position, and also the second rope bridge. It's also quite challenging if you want to go across the canyon. You can also go through the canyon. And finally, at the end, there's a wall which is about 4 or 5 meters high. It's also quite challenging. In between, well, it's exhausting, but not so difficult. And here we are. That's the end point for the hiking trail. Yeah, over there, the Via Ferrata starts. Have a look on the map. There you see. The key position, Schlüsselstelle. Also the second rope bridge over there. And the third over there. That are the 3 most difficult points. Yeah. Altogether, we need 4.5 hours until that. It's an additional 1 hour of hiking. Okay, now let's start. There we have the key position. Difficulty to see. Then we go for the first rope, which
the clock was a rope.
Okay, nice view from here. Not so difficult so far. Like a short break.
back.
You can see in here, sometimes smaller stones are coming down, so be careful. Always think about wearing a helmet. Safety first. The small canyon that this ferrata would pass quite quickly. There's always the risk of stones falling down. Already a nice view to the valley of the Inn. Following the Inn valley on the right side, we will end up at Innsbruck. On the left side, well, it's a longer way until Salzburg. Still quite cloudy. It's comfortable. Normally it's very hot here. So at least this time I don't get sunburned. Luckily. So let's continue. If someone is afraid of height, this might be a problem, but honestly, These parts are not difficult to climb. As long as you have good shoes. Which brings me to a very important point. Please always start climbing with good mountain shoes only. Some people like to climb with normal sport shoes. They are not suitable for climbing in the mountains. If you look in the distance, there are two small peaks. Right beside the small peak, there's a stone block with, well, more or less a rope bridge. Quite nice, and a little bit challenging part before to climb up to this two peaks. You see in the distance, there's still snow, so winter was long and there was a lot of snow at the end of the winter, so I hope we will have no snow fields up at the Battleworth hut. Okay, here we are at another canyon area with snowstorms coming down, so we have to pass fast. As you can see, they are always maintaining the ferrata. Here's the old part and they replaced it with a new part. So I assume the last maintenance was in May, beginning of the season. Okay, it's a little bit slippery and it's not enough. Because the cable is a little bit loose. But nevertheless, that works fine. Okay, here we are at the next descent. Again, the part they replaced. You see the old part here. Okay, let's see how I get the belay over the stone. That's not so good. Okay. Some sunshine over the valley, but not here. A lot of loose stones, you see that here. People should be careful. Doesn't this look impressive? Yeah, I know, not difficult, huh? Impressive. Hello. Right. We have a light overhang here. Hanging part here. Oh, we have to. It's a little bit more power. Here we go. Over there you can see already the second rope bridge.
Which is really a rope bridge.
Two rope Himalayan bridge. Recording works. So repo. Thank you. looks good. I will test the camera over the road bridge. This part here is a little bit challenging because it's slightly overhanging. So there's the trees and then it's gone.
all the way up to the double block.
You see the double blocks and continue from the right side. We are more or less going up, not sideward passages anymore, but still quite easy, but the view is better. Especially if you look down. Okay, let's continue.
Yes, wait. Oh.
This kind of walking is quite exhausting. Oof. Whew. For orientation, it's 11:45. part
which is slightly overhanging. It's manageable.
That was quite exhausting. Wow.
Let's continue. Thank you. Okay, let's continue with the last part. Well, it's really not long anymore. Over there, this nice warmth is a little bit challenging. I would expect this to be the most challenging part of this via ferrata. Just very short, but challenging. Study. You won't be at the app for 1:30 or even later. Exactly, these 4 or 5 meters. Thank you.
Okay, the challenging part is the steel rope is at the right side, whereas climbing is easy on the left side, but it's too far away. And there is absolutely no iron in the wall, so you have to be a little bit tricky. Okay, let's see. So it's pure rock rambling here, because you can't rely on the rope. See? Okay, that's it. Difficult part passed. Success. Yeah. quick look upwards. There's maybe 50-60 meters away where I see the plants. That's the end of the Via Ferrata. So trivial now, but don't underestimate. After the Via Ferrata, you have about, well, at least 1 hour hiking trail until there. Thank you.
Whew. That's it. Finished. Now hiking to the hut. Maybe a short lunch break in between. And that's it. Whew. Wow. Short impression from the hiking trail up to the Battle Dwarf hut. Quite exhausting. Yeah. The hiking trail also leads us through a, let's say, small forest. I don't know the name in English. Those are Latschenkiefern. When the sun is shining and it's a little bit wet, they smell very well, like the typical help bus. Oh, it's good breathing here. But, well, still not at the yard. Take some time. You can see it up there at the end of the lift. There's the hut. So, finished all the way. There's the Battle Wolf hut. For a short photo shooting, my goodness. That goes up to the peak of the Battle Wolf. I'm going this tour today.
some impressions from descent. There's still some spots of snow left. Not much, but it's white. Nice to see. Let's see how far I get without cramps. Quite often I might have cramps during descent. Some stones are a little bit wet. It's been raining for not longer than 5 minutes, but it was enough to make the stone slippery. And it's much fresher now. I have to wear a jacket. So, you see? There's still a lot of snow left. Okay. Let's see how easy it is to pass this position. Let's see. Now we can see whether the shoes are really good or not. I don't have any equipment for snow with me. So let's see.
about it. Some more impressions from descent. Well, this is quite an acceptable path to hike on, but it will get more difficult about in the last third of this way. Warm again, but I keep my jacket on because it might be possible that some more rainfall appears and then I'm not fast enough to get my jacket out of the bag again. Descent. Oh, the more interesting part here. Sun is back. Clouds only in the distance. It's getting warm, real warm. I don't know what happens with these dark clouds at the end of the valley, but they look dangerous.
I'm trying to make small steps to avoid cramps. That's not so easy. Yeah. good overview over the rest of our route. Yeah, exactly. Down there we have to go. Pass the canyon first. It looks pretty nearby, but it takes a while. Absam. This is not an area for recreation. We don't stop here because small stones can always come down here. So let's see that we can quickly pass on here. Just pinch it a little bit. Okay. Like you're walking over sand. There's no grip. Everything moves. Especially these big stones. Now 4:30. I assume I need another 1.5 hours to be back at my car. Crossing this area with these small rocks and stones is quite a lot of work. It takes a long time and you're sliding like you're walking on sand. Thank you.
once while sliding.